Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough! Let's go to the new area known as the Awakening Wood, right here, right now! Unlike my Pikmin 1 walkthrough, where I had basically one day per part, it's not gonna work that way in Pikmin 2. Namely because of those underground areas which basically freeze time, and yeah, I'm saying basically a lot, so let's try stop doing that. But so what's going to happen is that the parts, I should say the days, are going to be a lot longer because the time gets frozen underground.
Good morning. It should please you to know the purple Pikmin are lodged safely in my hall. The confines of my interior seem to suit them perfectly, though they do occasionally tickle me.
It can feel...
Send the ring of light below me and press A to call the purple Pikmin out.
Sounds good. Just like calling Pikmin out of the onion, under the onion, except, you know, it's out of the ship, so I guess the ship is its own onion. I was mashing the A button a little too quickly there. That is okay. Anyway, I'm gonna pull out every single Pikmin I have here and get this day going. Sound good? Good. You can press, while you're holding a Pikmin, you can use the D-pad to switch between Pikmin like that. And I'm gonna use purple to attack stuff and... Thanks for interrupting me.
Lily, has Olimar instructed you on the peculiarities of Pikmin creatures? The Pikmin form groups based on color when disbanded with X. Grabbing Pikmin with A also calls them the group by color. Now for the bonus lesson. After grabbing a Pikmin with A, you can press left or right on the D-pad to swap it for another color.
I would just describe this. Oh, forget it.
This is the first time you've heard this? Olimar, remember to properly train new employees.
Alright, I should still be holding it. Nope, I'm not still holding it. Dang. Well, anyway, this is the power of purple Pikmin. Yeah, I can stun enemies sometimes, and yeah, it also wipes out enemies pretty rapidly. I would like to attack that sleeping Bulbor. Well, you know, it's just a red Bulbor, but it's sleeping. From the back, using the purples first, just like this, and watch how fast its HP goes down! Yeah! It's so effective! It's super effective, I guess you could say. Oh, there we go. I just want to get a couple of Pikmin on each of these so that we can start breeding up our numbers here, because this is where the game really starts to get going, and I should also probably throw some Pikmin on this grass here, because... No, I want some of you guys... There you go. I want them to pluck... the grass, because it might contain some nectar, and the nectar can be used to flower up Pikmin rather rapidly. These are female sheer grubs, they are completely harmless, don't worry about them in the slightest. Just attack them and breed them for the Pikmin. Yes, the Pikmin breeding, so important. There's actually something in this flower pot here, but I can't actually get that right now until a little bit later, but keep this area in mind until then. Hey, you guys, stop, don't be stragglers. And... oh, shoot! I don't want them to drink that. Well, it happened. I'll be able to get more nectar later, though, anyway, so it doesn't really matter.
The Pikmin that drank the yellow nectar instantly matured into flower Pikmin! It appears to have enhanced motor skills. What a wondrous nectar!
And this is why you want to flower them. How intriguing.
Like plants, Pikmin mature from leaf to bud to flower. Captain Olimar, you must share the information you have with your subordinate, Luigi!
Louis, why did I say Luigi? Well, his name is based off of Luigi, but oh, we got another cutscene going on here. I must have reached 100 Pikmin.
Olimar, we have a problem. The onion has ceased ejecting seeds. Is it malfunctioning? Interesting. It now seems the number of life forms within the onion has increased. Didn't you know that no more than 100 Pikmin will venture onto the planet at once? But I currently observe only 95 on the surface. Could there be wild Pikmin somewhere?
Could there? Let's pause our game here to check the map. And oh, would you look at that! Over here at the far corner, there are indeed some wild Pikmin. The blue variety, but we won't be able to get those for quite a while. Anyway, I'd like to redirect these guys with the sea stick into the nectar to flower as many of these suckers as I possibly can. Now look at the difference in speed, yeah! You'll get the same result from leaving them in the ground like I showed you with the budding thing, but, you know, with the nectar, it's just so much faster. water is this way, can't go that way, so yeah. I'm just showing you around the area here really quick. There isn't all that much pressure here, because I'll only be able to visit, like, two of the underground areas this part anyway, based on the way that it's designed and the timing of stuff and whatnot. Ooh, unmarked spectralids! These can also give you nectar if you whack them out of the sky. Yeah, lots of nectar, actually. No, stop! They're so greedy. So greedy. Maybe I should grab my other teammates here, because they're kind of using up all the nectar, and that's kind of sucky. And I got a strawberry back to the ship, and this is actually a treasure. Yeah, but it's not a strawberry, it's a sunseed berry. Yep. Woo! 10% has already been recovered of the depth. So, anyway, let's start plucking these guys here, because we need all the Pikmin we can get in our squad. And yeah, and then I should probably go back over to those nectar droplets and flower them up. Just keep mashing at A. Yep, it's kind of tiring, but it's perfectly possible. Okay, there, I don't know what I'm saying here. Okay, let's, come on, yep, leaves. You're lagging behind now. Alright. That's not too bad. I'll let them bring... I'm feeling kind of impatient here, because I want to show some other stuff, and yeah, they'll only give like one or two Pikmin each for each of those butterflies, you know, the unmarked spectralids anyway. So yeah, it's not really that worth it. Now over here, we got something called burgeoning spider warts. See these berries at the top here? I'd like to actually throw them on the flower, but I don't think I can with... Oh, there we go. It just had to be weighed down a little bit. And they are going to knock those suckers off now. Well, eventually. And then they're going to start taking them back over to the ship. Now, the reason why I'm doing this is because, well... Oh, I gotta knock down this wall, by the way. Ooh, Honey Wisp. Honey Wisp, give me your nectar! Yeah! Honey Wisps always carry nectar on them. So, it's another easy way to flower Pikmin. Now, what is this berry here? Astounding! This red berry contains an ultra-spicy essence! It does not appear to have any monetary value, but I shall research potential uses for it. Bring me another specimen.
Okay.
And another one is on its way. Like, quite literally, it's on its way, because there's a couple of them taking them to the onion right then and there, so yeah. Hey, you. Hey, yeah. Everyone, hey, stop, come, yeah, thank you. Sometimes, I swear. The Pikmin just get all over the place. And wait, huh? Why are they taking so long to get back? Huh. I'll forget it. Anyway, come on, oh, there we go. Finally, there's the cutscene. I was waiting for it. Because I figured it only takes two berries to get this cutscene to work. Captain Olimar, a research on the red berries you discovered had yielded a powerful potion. Behold, the Ultra Spicy Spray! Although it is untested, I believe it will have spectacular results. Spray it on all your Pikmin by pressing down on the D-pad. When necessary, I can produce one bottle of spray from 10 berries. Pressure... Start pause to contact me and confirm your berry count. Look at L on the radar screen. So, you go here... And you go, like, here... And then, yeah, there you go. And now, I'm just going to let them take that stuff back, and then I am going to hope that they're going to be finished with that black wall, because those black walls have a lot of HP, well, typically. So, how is the progress going, guys? It's on stage two. Everyone on! Get that wall down! I'm cheering! Look at my arm, I'm cheering! Yeah, you can punch by pressing the A button. This is going to be used to do minor damage to enemies. See that thing in the ground there? With that looks like an eye with a blue body? That is an enemy. Yep. It's a cloaking burrownet. It doesn't look like an enemy right now, but it is most certainly an enemy. And it has this long tongue that can lap up Pikmin. Watch us. I just want to show its attack. Nope, not gonna show your attack, huh? Come on, though. Come on, work with me here. I just gotta show the people. Come on. Come on. There we go. That's its move. Attack! Woo! I think I'm gonna leave it behind. The reds in this game aren't really super useful. So, yeah. Reds in the first game were like the most useful type, but this is a creeping chrysanthemum. See that? It's got an eye. Look at that on the left side of the screen there. See, I'm pointing at it there. Look out! It's an easy enemy, but if it surprises you, it'll do some damage. But yeah, it's actually a pretty weak enemy if you know what you're looking for. There we go. Voila, and I can have Pikmin take all the stuff back to the ship, actually. Well, I'll do that a little bit later. What do we have here? Can I squish this down? No, 200, that's way too many. I need more purples. So yeah, I'll do this later on, when my Pikmin are doing something else. For now, let's go through here, and poison gates, cannot get through that. Well, it's actually poison pipes underneath the gate, and if a Pikmin gets into it, watch this, I'll just show you here real quick. Come on, just get poison here for a sec. I know that sounds bad, but that's... There we go! There we go. Oh no! The cuteness! Emergency! Pikmin are severing! If you blow your whistle with B, you may be able to help them. And so yeah, I'm gonna blow it just to get it. Oh, I already did it. Okay, good, good, very good. Anyway, there's another hole in the ground over here, so I should probably go and go inside it. But no, I gotta do a cutscene first, of course. In fact, there's one on every hole. My logical sensors are reacting violently. The readings are ominous. A beast of unknown power lurks in these depths. A large Pikmin group would be reassuring. This is about as big as I can get it. My sound sensors are picking up a hostile roars of many beasts. Expect dangerous encounters. Sensors are also showing extreme heat pockets. You may need flame-resistant Pikmin. Red are flame-resistant! Do not throw the purples into fire, though. But my records indicate no such data. Are my records incomplete? No. Well, okay, yeah. Anyway, let's go in with our entire Pikmin squad. You'll notice that there was a couple of circles at the top of the screen. One of them had a fire in it. Those circles indicate which elements are inside the hole. I think some are inaccurate, though. But that's okay. I typically have a full squad of all sorts of different kinds of Pikmin anyway. Because, you know, Pikmin can do multi-different tasks and whatnot. Yeah, you get what I'm saying here. Anyway, Hole of Beasts, sub-level 1, here we go. Let's look around. Now, remember that the layout of this place may not be the same layout as the layout of your game file thing. Because every time you go into here, the place resets. I should say the place shuffles around. And, yeah, some floors are the same while other floors are not. Like, see, the map is, it's like foggy of war, and fog of war, but it's all foggy and you can't tell where it is, but it's gonna keep drawing itself as I move through the cavern. Like, here the corner is coming up, so then the corner is going to be added to the map, see that? And now since I can see into this room, because, you know, the darkness is, male sheer grub, not good, those can kill Pikmin. They're much more dangerous in the first game, though. Here we have a D-pad, but I would like to make sure the path is clear before you start taking that back, because while Pikmin are taking stuff back, they're kind of helpless. So let's not take any chances here. Hey, female, yeah, you. I'd like to whack you around just for kicks. They're harmless, but I just want to whack them around for kicks. I'm not really even bothering to take them back to the onion or anything like that, because they yield very little results in terms of monetary value in comparison to, like, treasure and whatnot. So, yeah, I'm pretty much gonna skip taking enemies back to the ship underground, unless they're in the way, because it's not really necessary. The Stone of Glory! By the way, if you can't tell, this is a NES D-pad, because the NES D-pad has these arrows instead of, like, arrows that look like that, excuse me, instead of other different looking arrows or lines or whatever like that, so yeah. Oh! I think the floor is clear, but I still like to look around here to see what we have around here. By the way, still remember to touch any sorts of plants that you see around here, as they'll get added to the Piklopedia, and ooh, another male. But yeah, you're actually most likely going to just touch them automatically without even noticing them, and they're going to get added to the Piklopedia. But yeah, it looks like we're done here, so we could just move on to the next floor. I don't really care if there's anyone lagging behind at this point now, because as soon as I go into the hall, you know, you see there's 94 out of 95 of my party, because some sort of dismissed themselves because they got too far away. But when I go into the next floor from here, it's just going to, you know, put them all back together in the party. So yeah, once all the enemies are cleared in the floor, or you know the pathway is cleared just in general, you can just rush over to the hall and move on. It's also a pretty quick way to get through these places if you aren't really keen on collecting treasure, but you kind of want to collect the treasure for the depth and whatnot, and plus, you know, 100%ing, so yeah. Let's take a look around carefully. Let's break this egg. It might have something good in it. Oh, nectar! Eat! Nom 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 nom! Nom 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 nom! I think there's like, yeah, there's two leaves left in here. Oh no, wait, three leaves, okay. Just a few left to flower here. Got some more violet candy pop buds, which you most certainly want to transform Pikmin with. This seems to be a pretty enemy-less level, isn't it? Yeah! So it's probably a completely safe floor. It's probably more like a bonus floor more than anything. They have those sorts of floors in these underground areas. Okay. Let's look around this way, because I seen that it loops around a little bit. Oh, wait, no, it doesn't. Oops. Because I seen darkness, and I thought it was looping around, but it's just the roundness of the corner, and yeah. I don't want to leave here just yet. I want to take a look around. I mean, yeah, I can tell the floor is complete because the Pikmin are singing, which means that the floor is complete, but I might be missing some other ways to power up Pikmin, like, you know, another egg or something like that. So, oh wait, does it? Oh yeah, that's right, I should have flowered Pikmin after turning them into purples, but eh, whatever. Okay, now I have two. Anyway, you definitely want to get as many purples as you can, because you're going to actually need 100 purples for one of the treasures in this game. So yeah, like quite literally 100 purples, because the thing that you have to carry is so dang heavy. Next floor, go! Woo! Oh yeah. Always remember, do not go to the next floor unless you are satisfied with the results. Feel free to soft reset or reset the game. You can soft reset by pressing and holding, Start, B, and X at the same time. I'm not sure what it is for the Wii version offhand, though, because I don't have the Wii version, as I said before. Oh, flame geysers! This time, in this game, you can actually whack them with red Pikmin, and they all close up so that other Pikmin can cross them. Oh yeah. That is the power of using Pikmin elements. Because red Pikmin are completely immune to them. You can use purple Pikmin or any other color of Pikmin to close these geysers off, but you're kind of risking the chance of Pikmin, you know, getting fire. I actually should show the cutscene for when a Pikmin gets burned, so watch this. I'll just throw one in there. Oh no! Oh no! Emergency! Pikmin are suffering! If you blow your whistle with B, you may be able to help them. Yeah, it's the same as poison, basically, in that it'll kill them if you let it go for too long. Yeah. So, I just wanted to show it with just one Pikmin, just in case it goes awry. Over here we have I can't tell, it's kind of dark. Oh, it's one of those things from Mahjong. Yeah, one of those Mahjong tiles. It's a seven circle. Anyway, I gotta take care of these geysers. Go, 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 go. Go, 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 go. Yeah. Oh, no. I was a little too hasty there. I'm sorry. Okay, moving on. This is gonna fire, of course. Yeah, of course it will. Look at this. It's a Famicom disc. Love this sort of stuff. The other Pikmin should be... Yeah, I was gonna say, the other Pikmin should be back with that tile by now. Alright, 150 for a tile. Strife Monolith! And this is gonna take these guys a little while, so... Let's follow him back! Let's look around for the kicks. And yeah, you can actually go in here, but you can't actually see in there. Like, if you go in the map, it's just a complete dead end. It's at, it's this right here in this blurry map. So, yeah. The way that the map looks like when you enlarge it like that is when you, expand the size of an image. Like in Photoshop or GIMP or something like that. And what do we have here? What do they call it? Cosmic Archive! Did we get everything? I think so. Yep. I'm pretty sure. Yep. So let's go to the next floor! Woo! Things are going pretty well, I have to say. This pleases me greatly because I won't have to do cuts. Yes, think of the editing. Think of the editing. Sublevel 4 of the Hall of Beasts. Go. Ooh, so sinister. So sinister. What do we have here? Should probably take that out right away with some purples. Oh, it had something. Doesn't this look like a Game & Watch thing? It is indeed a Game & Watch thing. Anyway, I'm gonna have them take that back. No, I want you guys to be in my party. You attack that fire geyser. You attack this egg. There might be some goodies in there. But anyway, let's see what they call the Game & Watch thing. Dream Architect. Alright. I got some more nectar, which I'll save for the leaves that are in here somewhere. but first, let's take a look around here. Well, there's the exit to the floor, but we don't want to do that yet. We gotta look around and see what we're missing here. Because the Pikmin aren't singing, which means that there's still treasure to be found. And we have to get all the treasure to 100% the game. There's this area right here. I can go right through here, right? With Pikmin, they'll go through easy. Yeah, I thought so. Hey, it's a playing card! And another Violet Candy Pop Bud. Take that. Good boys. Wait, I got reds on that. Okay, I was gonna say, if there's any purple on that, and they go through a flame geyser on the way back, that would have sucked. Because I wouldn't have been there to blow the whistle to free them from their pain, basically. Alright, got 92, and 3 are on the card. It's a Nintendo playing card! It's so weird how it spins. Luck Wafer! Yeah, Nintendo makes playing cards, too. They originally made Hanafuda cards, actually. Like, before they started making video games. Oh, wait, what am I carrying this back for? I'm not gonna get Pikmin out of this. Anyway, let's see if I can get those leaves flowered all at once, everyone together, and into the nectar! Okay, I think I got it. But, oh, no, there's one leaf! Dang it! I mean, you don't have to flower all your Pikmin for 100% or anything like that, but I just like the higher performance of Pikmin, you know, that have flowers over leaves. But anyway, where's the leaf? There it is! Now we're all flowered up! Sweet! And now we can move on to the next floor because the Pikmin are singing, everyone's flowered, it was a pretty easy floor overall. But oh no, don't get too comfortable because the final floor is the next floor. And we have something waiting for us. Well, maybe it's not waiting for us in specific, but it's waiting for passerbys. Hall of Beasts, sublevel 5. Oh boy! You can tell this floor is different already by the ground. Oh! Listen. See that? See that over there? Let's grab a couple Pikmin. Well, maybe just one Pikmin, just to be safe here, and not a purple Pikmin. Let's take a look around here. Uh-oh. This is moving, isn't it? It's moving, isn't it? Oh, it's sleeping. Let's throw one on there. Get it off! Get it off! Run! Behold the boss known as Empress Bulblax! And what you want to do is preferably attack it with purples right on the head, like this, and then call him off before it does a roll. Because if it does a roll and Pikmin are off to its sides, you will not be pleased because it's going to squish the Pikmin. So yeah, let's just play this safe, let's just whack it with purple Pikmin, and we will be perfectly fine. Just keep repeating this over and- Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, shoot. Did I lose one? Oh, I lost one! It got squished. Oh, that's so sad. So, so sad. Because it threw it away from my whistle and I didn't notice it. That's okay, though. Yep. Purples have some high attack power for sure. Get him off, get him off. Okay, careful. Careful, careful. I just knew I was going to lose on because I seen that I had 24 Pikmin in my squad. And I know that I had 25 purple Pikmin. They're like, ah. It had to be multiples of 5 because every time I went into the violet candy pop buds, you know, you get 5 out of that. Call him off, call him off. It's going to roll, it's going to throw him around. Finish it. Yeah! I win! That is pretty gross. Ooh, a love tester. This is the toy that gives you, like, a sort of random result as to how compatible you are with a partner. How bizarre. This device is emitting black light. It must have been ingested by that creature. What an absolutely repulsive life form. Our return to Hakate cannot come soon enough. No kidding, that thing was... Ooh, it smells. Okay, let's just take this stuff back. And I suppose I'll take the boss back just for the fun of it here. It doesn't really take all that many, despite its flabbiness. It's because I deflabbed it upon squishing it, and, you know, destroying it, yeah. That's probably going to get there a lot faster. I was going to say this is going to get there a lot faster than Empress Bulblax, but it's going about the same rate. Probably because of the weight differences. And I'm going to wait over here, because they still got to take that treasure back. What's it called? Prototype detector.
This contraption seems to react when approaches treasure. I will connect it to my radar. Processing complete. The treasure cage is now fully operational. It will now appear on your monitor. The needle will remove right as you approach treasure.
So yeah, it's a love tester, but I guess it's been converted into a treasure detector, and now you won't have to worry about listening for the Pikmin singing, you know, if a floor is clear. You'll have a much more clear indication of it at the bottom right corner of the screen there. And I love being able to point with my whistler. Anyway, I think it's about time I end off this part here, because it's been going on for a while. It's took on quite a while, actually, a lot longer than I thought it would, but that's okay. So with that, I'm going to end off the party here. Hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part. Oh yeah, I forgot all about the treasure. Silly me. Yeah, here's the treasure count. Okay,